Yes, they are. They're doing a documentary on the life and times of Bill Plaschke. You like that? You like that?
I really loved sports, and I loved to write. Those are my two loves, and that's what got me started in my career, is that I realized that I can have my love of sports and my love of writing and do it all at the same time by being a sports writer. Probably the most memorable LA sports moment was it was in the year 2000, and the Lakers were playing the Portland Trail Blazers in Game 6 of the Western Conference Finals.
The Lakers have two. Bryant to shoot.
And Lakers were down 15 points in the fourth quarter, and they came back and won that game, and that started the dynasty. It was unbelievable. I was so breathless. I could barely sit and write my story. It was a breathtaking moment that I could barely. Also, I was there for Fernando Valenzuela's no-hitter, and that was an amazing thing. And that was another thing where you finish the game ends, and it's just crazy. But then I was there when the Angels this year threw a no-hitter against the Dodgers and lost. And that was a crazy time. So the thing about sports is so great is that you never know what's going to happen. It's the only thing in life where you go out and cover it. It's the only event where there's no, you don't know what the ending's going to be. The Kirk Gibson home run, 1988. I was leaving the press box, and I was going to go downstairs to do the interviews. The game was over. Dennis Eckersley was pitching. Dodgers were done. It was over with. I go to the elevator. It opens up. I get on the elevator, and an old lady comes by, and she needs to be on the elevator, so you have to hold it open for an extra 10 seconds. And I can see and I can hear through the press box, now batting Kirk Gibson. I thought, oh my God, wait a minute, he's going to hit. The elevator is closing. I jumped off the elevator. It closed. It took everybody downstairs. I stayed and I got to watch it in person, thank goodness. And it was amazing. And it was just the thing, that was surreal. It's just one of those times you just don't believe what you saw. And in sports, that happens all the time. No, I can't have any fair teams. It's against the rules. I can't cheer. And that's one thing I'm kind of sad about is that I see a lot of my friends who cheer for teams. I can cheer for no team because it's not fair. But I do cheer for Los Angeles. I cheer for the LA, for the city. So if the Lakers are going good, I'm going to be writing good things about them. If they're going bad, I'm going to be really ripping them because I think that it's not good for the city.
Three facially coiffed sports writers and babyface Mariotti.
It's Around the Horn, presented by Nissan. Here's Tony Reale.
Welcome back to the show of competitive banter. Let's say hello to the competitors in Los Angeles, Bill Plaschke.
One of the coolest things about the All-Star game last night, George Sherrill's cap.
Yeah, well, my daily routine is I get up 7:15, and at 7:30 a.m. we have a conference call for Around the Horn where we talk about the day's issues to see who agrees about what we're going to talk about. Conference call lasts about 45 minutes, and I spend the next 45 minutes doing research for the show. Then I get in the car, drive down to the LA Times building, come to the studio, tape the show from 10 to 11. Then at 11 o'clock, the show's taped, it's done. I leave, and then I start my day. Then I start finding columns, talking to my boss, seeing what I'm going to write about that day. And then I may end up working until midnight if I'm covering a Laker game that night. So I work anywhere from, 10 to 15 to 16 hours a day. Thing about my job, the most important thing is all I have is my credibility. And people say, well, go talk to your boss. What does your boss say about this or that? My boss is the reader. My boss is a guy that puts 50 cents or 75 cents in the box and takes a paper and trusts me. That's my boss. I write for him. And it's a sacred, sacred duty to be true and honest with my feelings to the reader. Therefore, if I like a player and he does bad, I have to criticize him. I can't say, well, he's my buddy. Or if a player and I have spent the day talking about our kids, and we've gone out after the game for a drink, and then 2 days later, the player messes up. I've got to write that he messes up. I can't have favorites, so it's hard to have any lasting friendships in this business with athletes or coaches because you always have to be critical of them, because my goal is to serve the reader of Los Angeles and to let him know that he's getting the unfiltered truth from me without any personal likes or dislikes. It's just whatever I feel is, is good or bad, I'm writing that based on what I see. Oh, sports, yes, that's why I like to do sports. Sports is the one language we all share. Sports is something everyone understands. You're the President of the United States. If he has a good bill that he passes, he says, I hit a grand slam. You have, if you have a guy who makes a mistake at work, he says, oh, I muffed that. People always use sports phrases for everything because it's the language you understand. It's what binds us together. And it's so cool is that, and also in L.A. particularly, sports is the only thing in L.A. that everybody cheers for. If I write about the governor, nobody cheers for the governor. They either like him or don't like him. They kind of just notice him. If I write about city council, if I write about the water board or the police, everybody just kind of notices them. But nobody actively cheers for them. They actively cheer for what I write about. So sports binds us together. It brings us together in something everybody can understand and everybody can rally around. And it can bring a community of diverse people together under one color. You see the purple and gold of Lakers being worn by Latinos, Asian Americans, African Americans, people from Riverside, people from Santa Monica. They all come together, and it's the only thing that does that.
Oh, no! Oh, no! I can't win with the Argyle! Yes, I know. Thank you. The lights are off. I'm done. Thank you. Goodbye.